to the garage. We're here today to build a small fence for the inside of the house. Now the living room is kind of under construction. We've got some repairs and some remodels we're doing. The carpet's all torn up. The couches are moved out. We're trying to make a little fence to keep the dogs out of the living room, keep them out of the mess. So that's what we're here to do today. Now, what's special about this project today is I'm going to be using no power tools. Now, some of these techniques are highly advanced, and you need to consult a professional like myself before attempting any of these techniques. Now, you can see I have here, this will be the main cutting tool for today. This is an axe. Some of you may or may not be familiar with a device like this. I've got it set up in a clamp, and this will be making most of our cuts today. This is some scrap material that I've had in the garage here for a little bit. You'll find that wood wants to be cut. You saw the pencil fly. It tried to fly right towards that axe. Wood just is begging to be cut. I didn't plan that at all. This pencil has just been pulling itself. I will show you how this works. Again, if you don't have an axe, then you probably don't know how to use one, and I wouldn't even think about trying anything like this. Very advanced.
A good square is very important for making things square.
All right, we've got our setup here generally laid out the way that we want it. Again, precision is key. Now, I've still got the sheath on there because if I set this board down straight on the blade, it would just cut it off, and I'm not quite ready to do that. Get a final alignment over the blade. We're eyeballing, ensuring square, and we're just gonna drop this from about a foot or maybe a little bit more onto the cutting edge. It will just slice that right off. Okay, you can see I did leave a little chunk there. Now, that's probably because this needs to be sharpened, and I'll fix that on the next cut, as you will see in just a moment. All right, got my sharpener. I'm just going to take a little bit off there. Had that little bit of tear out. I should have sharpened this beforehand. Cut. Lined up. Everything square. Lift and alignment, lift, and drop. Perfect. That sharpening really helped. Much better, much cleaner cut. Now this one, I won't drop so far so that I can control a little better where the cut happens. This does take a lot of practice. Okay. Drill bit, simply place it where you want, push down. Okay, there we go. That one's done. Same on the other side, exact same. Push. All right. And that should be pretty much it for those. Sometimes with the screws, doing two at a time can also work. Just get them in there. And that's good. Thank you.
All right, I've got all the, the slats. I don't know what they're called. I've got all these pieces cut and pre-drilled. Layout is pretty easy. You just you put your pieces in the order that you want them, a big, too small. Now this does, again, this takes a little bit of practice, but you're basically just gonna take this stack of your wood and you're just gonna throw it, and it should lay out pretty good, pretty close. So just like this. All right, there we go. That may take some further refinement. All right, it's much later in the day. I kind of had some stuff going on there in the middle, but here's the finished product. Just a simple fence to keep the dogs out of the construction area while work is in progress. That is how to build an indoor fence. I hope you enjoyed. Use caution. Some of these techniques, again, are very, very advanced. And that axe, if properly sharpened, you see it just cuts a board right in half, very clean. So just be very careful. Thanks for watching.